So I'm now in my homepage or dashboard or however you want to call it. I have already created something. You guys will have a blank slate as soon as you log in for the first time. So we're going to create something. This will be a document. And we are going to call this our practice file. We will load up the workspace and we will have a couple of different sections of the screen. We will have a feature bar up here. We will have a history of features that we create over on our left-hand side. And then we have the model field where we have our three planes, our cube, our arrows, and things like that. We'll have the title up here. We can change that title if we wanted to. Practice test. Doesn't super matter. I'm going to be using just my touchpad just in case you don't have a mouse. And that way, I'm clicking on things and doing things the same way that you would be doing things. Okay, so from the beginning, let's just play around with how to maneuver around our view. We have arrows that we can rotate our view. Now, if we ever get to a wonky orientation that we don't end up liking, we can always go back to isometric using this drop-down arrow. That will take us to a perfectly isometric view. We can also click on these corners of our cube to get sort of isometric views, more cabinet or cavalier views. We can click on faces so we can get directly straight on two-dimensional faces. Now, our arrows are kind of opposite to how we view things. When we click the up arrow, we're not rotating upward through it. We are kind of flipping it on its head. And that's that. If we wanted to start a sketch, we will click on sketch and then we'll click on a plane. Now, this is always going to be here. As soon as we click that check mark, then we're done sketching, and we would have to go back into the sketch by double clicking on this sketch one on our model pane. We can click on the front face on the view cube, and then we can start playing around with our different features. So that's a line. We just created an enclosed space because we know it's enclosed because it's a orange dot square system. That is something that we can extrude later. If we wanted to delete those things, Control Z will undo things. We can do the same thing with our arrow keys up here, back and forth. We can also click and drag, selecting things and deleting things that way. Go ahead and try that out. We have rectangles that we can make, circles that we can make, two clicks, a center point, and then a radius. We have arcs. Those are three points, first point, second point, and then a radius. You can change those to different kinds of arcs. A center point arc, you would set the center point first and then initialize the start stop of the curve. We can do polygons as well. Actually, I'm gonna clear the screen. Before I do that, so if we click on our polygon, then we can create polygons of various number of sides. So after we do our first click and our second click, then we can initiate how many sides there are, and those sides will be tangential to the radius that we created. Now afterwards, when we escape out, we can always double click on this. I don't want this to be a pentagon, I want this to be a hexagon, so we'll change that to six sides. And that's how that works. We have a spline tool, allows us to make amorphous shapes. If we double click at the end, then that will finalize the spline. Again, these features are very similar to Autodesk Inventor, what you would have been using had COVID-19 not presented such a threat. So let's make something. We know how to do a rectangle, so let's initiate a rectangle. Now say I want to make this a specific size. These rectangles with numbers would automatically pop up. We can change those right now without touching anything. We could change that to 5. Don't know how many, if that's inches or millimeters, we'll talk about that later. And then it shifts to the next text box, and we can change that to 3. There's another way that we can do that. We can dimension using this dimension feature. If you hover over something, then it will give you instructions. If it has a letter within parentheses, then that means that we can hit it on the keyboard. I just hit D on my keyboard, and I can click on the two lines that are opposite each other, change it to 5, and then that is now a 5-inch or millimeter, a 5-unit side. I can also just click on one of the sides, and that will create a dimension that is parallel to that side. I'll change that to 3. And those are two ways that I can dimension something. One of the differences that I wanted to explain between Autodesk Inventor and Onshape is that there isn't a chamfer option that I can do on a sketch. I can only chamfer on a 3D feature. What we're going to do next is new. It's called a fillet. So we are going to hit that fillet button. We're going to click on a corner. We're going to say, okay, there's my fillet. That's the corner that I wanted to hit. Now I want to change this. It looks like our units are inches. So we're going to change that to a 1-inch fillet. That means that the radius of curvature is going to be 1 inch. Go ahead and do a fillet on two corners, doesn't matter which. You can do it on this northeast corner, southeast corner, southwest, doesn't matter. But I want you to make those two different sizes. So we're gonna make this 1/2 inch. I can do 0.5 inches. We'll do 0.5 to make your physics teachers happy. Or we could do 1.5. Now it looks like it also made this guy 1/2 inch, so we'll change that. That's interesting. Never mind. I'm playing with this just as I'm making these videos. So we'll have these two fillets be the same length or the same dimension. So now let's work with something called extend and trim. So in order to do that, let's make a squiggly line through our shape. Let's finish that off. Gosh, these touchpads sort of stink. Let's do an S through it to make sure that we have lines extending outside of our shape. And then let's make a line in the middle of it, but not quite hitting the edge. Okay, so let's say we now want to trim off the axis over here. We have a pair of scissors up here, and we have a drop down, and we have trim, extend, and split. Our hotkeys for trim is M. The hotkey for extend is X. So let's trim the top and bottom of our S curve. And then let's extend our line out to the edge. So how we do that is we click on our line and then we click to the face, edge, side, however you say it, that we want it to extend to. So now we have a line that extends all the way out. And we don't have anything going outside of our shape. We have points here, but those are important for setting the curvature of our spline. So if we click and drag, then that changes what our S curve looks like. And that's really the basic what you sort of need. You know, polygons, circles, curves, lines, how to manipulate those lines by extending and trimming, you know, fillet, and you know how to sort of manipulate things with dimensioning and by clicking and dragging points that we see. And with that, we can start working on our next part of our tutorial. So hang out and let's get going.